Cleveland, Ohio, home of the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, Lake Erie, and a slightly rusty bridge. And just across that bridge is murder. The ghost hunters have been called in to investigate a working rail yard and service station that are close to the dumping grounds of the Cleveland Torso Murderer, as well as some trains. In the 1930s, the Cleveland Torso Murderer, also known as the Mad Butcher of Kingsbury Run, murdered and dismembered at least 12 victims in the Cleveland area. Overseeing the investigations was this man. Unfortunately, this grainy reenactment is the only evidence of the killings the police had to go off of. Midwest Railway Preservation Society, Cleveland, Ohio. The case of the spooky train ghost. The railway roundhouse was built in 1907. Working the rail yard back then was a dangerous job. Numerous injuries, pregnancies, and deaths occurred on the site. One of the most dangerous jobs on the site was that of the wave man, who had to walk on top of moving train cars and wave hello to the people outside. Sometimes, terrifying things would happen, such as a wave man dropping his expensive hat from the top of a moving train. In addition to reports of hearing mysterious noises in the roundhouse, people have also spotted ghostly clip art looming about. There have been other sightings in the yard where train cars are restored, such as the Death Car, so named for a 1943 accident where a train car named the Dining Car was misspelled as the Death Car on its train birth certificate. Claims on the Death Car include shadow figures, a voice whispering for them to get out, and sightings of a creepy man named Alex Cyprus. Here's Alex Cyprus, a member of the Midwest Railway Preservation Society, who recalls a tale of all the windows slamming shut on the car just before he entered the women's restroom. In the Mount Baxter car, visitors claim to feel the presence of 4 to 5 spirits, especially in the number 7 bunk, where a woman passed away here in her sleep. Visitors also report strange feelings occurring in the kitchen, such as a rumbly tummy, accompanied with a desire for a sandwich. All these anecdotes are enough to convince the ghost hunters to set up shop at the rail yard to look for any possible paranormal activity. What you're about to see is unedited footage of the ghost hunters' night at the roundhouse. Viewer discretion is advised.
EMF 0.2.
Hello? Can you please tell us your name?
You should come out and talk to us. I love train travel.